Welcome to Nature Book Review, a video showcasing books on nature and wildlife.
Butterflies, most colorful of all insects, have a unique life cycle. The female lays eggs on a food plant. The caterpillar feeds on the leaves of the food plant, sometimes flowers, sometimes birds, sometimes fruits. And then caterpillar, after growing to certain stage, pupates. And from the pupa, the adult comes. So there are four different life stages: adult, egg, caterpillar, and pupa. All these life stages do not resemble each other. There's a complete change in the body form. Hence, butterflies show complete metamorphosis. They are called as the holometabolous insect. Sahyadri, or the Western Ghat, stretches for almost 1500 kilometers, runs parallel to the west coast of India, and in one of the highest biodiversity hotspots. So here is the book that tells us about Butterflies of Western Ghat by Milind Bhakare and Hemant Ogle.
A Guide to the Butterflies of Western Ghats, India by Milind Bhakare and Hemant Ogle includes butterflies of Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Goa, Maharashtra and Gujarat states. There's a photograph of a yamfly butterfly with ants nearby. Let's go through the book. The book has been published by the authors themselves. Here are the credentials given. Yes, let's go through the exhaustive contents. About the authors: dedication, acknowledgement, foreword, preface, nomenclature and classification of butterflies, Western Ghat map, about Western Ghat, about butterfly, then butterfly morphology, life cycle, behavior, enemies, survival strategies, etc. Then introduction to species account, butterflies species description, family wise, Hesperidae, that is keepers, Lycaenidae, that is blues, Rhyodinidae, that is metal marks and judies, Nymphalidae, that is brush footed, Peridae, whites and yellows, Papilionidae, swallowtails, importance of butterflies and need of conservation, then A to F appendix. Appendix A on list of endemic species of Western Ghats. Appendix B is scheduled species list. Then Appendix C is field identification keys. Appendix D is eggs, larvae, pupae. Appendix E is larval food plants. Appendix F is state-wise distribution. Then comes glossary and abbreviations, references and additional reading, index of scientific name and index of common name. You see, the contents are very exhaustive and they occupy entire page. Let's go through the book. It's about authors, dedication, a foreword, acknowledgement, then nomenclature, about the geographical area. You can see the text is not in specific column. Of course, it is in single column, but arrangement varies on the left or right. It depends on the photograph. The font size is readable. Here it is in two columns. Font size is, as I said, is crisp and readable. The butterfly wing morphology described, then different sexual characters, life cycle, enemies, then survival strategies, then mimicry, nicely explained with the photograph of a host and a mimic. Then butterfly diet, butterfly migration. There's a photograph of a blue tiger, you can see plenty of them. Then family wise. Okay, now here is a keyword, how to use the abbreviations in the description. For example, UPF is upper side of the forewing. Likewise, it is explained. Then family Hesperidae starts with the list of genera and species. So you can see here in a specific species page, the photographs are given of a male, egg-laying female, mud-puddling, egg-laying female, etc. Then of course different life stages, right from egg to pupa. Pale green olet. Of course, other than wild photograph, there are few photographs from the museum specimens as well. So you can see it's amazingly illustrated. Each species is described with plenty of photographs. Then there are similar species, how to differentiate in the field. Like there are three species of banded owls, so how to differentiate based on the band is also given right here. So you can see it is, the book is stuffed with amazing number of photographs. Then a page mark with the butterfly on it. Silver royal. It is endemic to Western Ghats. So the species which are endemic, they have been identified as a green dot over here, and Schedule 2 species in Wildlife Protection Act of India, they are identified by a red text and dot over here. So like common cerulean, you can see different wet season morph, dry season morph, and differentiating characters. So when has to describe or see the species description, you have to also look at the photograph, because there are some pointers given over here like this. There are some species which are similar and found in nearby areas, like this Singhalese hedge blue. So it says there are no recent record of this species from India, but it is found in Sri Lanka. But it is highly probable that it might be present in Western Ghats. So it is a good comparative account. So if somebody encounters and cannot identify, see this page. Then in tigers, what is the scent pouch identified with the arrow. So you can see overall there's a nice distribution of photographs everywhere. Each species is described fantastically. So there's a scientific name, then what are the features, habits, habitat, similar species, subspecies, early stages, explain. The only flaw which I see in this book is, of course the stages are described nicely, but that doesn't tell us about the duration of the life stage, life form. Of course it varies season wise, I know, but it would have been easy to as a data. Then of course the size is not explained, size of a caterpillar, how it varies from when it comes out of the egg till it matures to form a pupa. So that sizes are not given, that's the only problem, but of course it's not of common use. Then importance of butterflies, conservation of butterflies, then appendix. Yeah, this is very fantastic section. Field identification keys explain nicely, very very nicely with the help of photographs. Then different types of eggs. You can see the exhaustive photography done by the authors. Of course they have borrowed photograph from other photographers, and they have been credited exactly at the photograph itself. Yes, then larval host plant, this is very important list. Then state wise distribution. Then list of scientific name, index of scientific name, index of common names, and there are sincere thanks. So you can see this is a very big book. It must be around 1.5 kg, but overall it's a fantastic book on natural history of butterflies of Western Ghats. Of course it is not a field guide, you cannot carry it while you are butterflying, but you can carry it to your camp. So when you come back, you can compare your photographs and identify using this book. A very, very beautiful book.